Good morning to all the students. We are going to start reported speech, which is the last topic of grammar. We have already completed literature. Fine, writing skills are also done. Only revision will be done now. And one topic is left from term one, okay? That is reported speech. And anybody who speaks will be coming here to write on the board. Don't give any stupid argument. Fine. So reported speech. Firstly, let me tell you what is reported speech. Clear? So there are two ways in which we can report the words of a speaker. Fine. There are two ways in which we can report the words of a speaker. Last voice, my voice is audible. So first way is if I say he said to me, I am feeling unwell today. Means you are directly quoting the words of the speaker. That is the first way. Fine. And second way is if I say, he said that he was feeling unwell that day. So we change the pronoun here. That he said, wo keh raha hai ki wo theek nahi hai. In that way. That is another way. Wo keh raha hai ki main theek nahi hu. Meaning remains the same, but the way you convey the speech of the speaker, that is different. Clear? In very easy language, the way we teach class 6th and 7th, I'm going to start from scratch. Fine? So if anybody will be disturbing, then you have to suffer. So let's start with what is reporting verb, what is reported speech. There are two. And in English, you cannot use abbreviations for different. You are writing DIF. No, it is not required. So there are two different ways in which we can report the words in which we can report the words of a speaker. First one is direct speech. Kindly maintain the speed because I'll be erasing also. Direct speech, indirect speech. It can take 2 days also, this topic. If I'll be able to wind up today, I'll try. If not, then by tomorrow. Fine, because we are not in rush to finish our syllabus now. Yes. There are two different ways in which we can report the words of a speaker. First is direct speech. Second is indirect speech. Clear? Now I'll be giving you example beneath only. Direct speech. Now the way I told you, he said, I'm feeling unwell. Anything you can write. He said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. He said to me, I am feeling unwell. Full stop, inverted comma, closes. Clear? Now, indirect speech, example of indirect speech, answer to this only. He told me that he was feeling unwell. He told me that he was feeling I'll be discussing better all about commas, inverted commas and all. Fine. He was feeling unwell. Fine. Now, in this Now I'll be discussing few rules with you all. See the difference. In direct speech, we have comma. In indirect speech, last boy, beta, please, it is visible to you. In direct speech, we use comma. In indirect speech, comma is not there. We remove it. Number one, that is first rule. In second rule is, in direct speech, we use inverted commas. Why? If I say, Mahatma Gandhi said, comma, inverted comma, start. Be the change you wish to see in the world. Ye sach mein Mahatma Gandhi ne bola tha. Kisi ke exact words quote karoge, then you will be using inverted commas. Fine. If you will change it in your own words, then you will not be using inverted commas. Okay? So here we will use comma and inverted commas. Here we will not be using commas and inverted commas. Second rule. Clear? Now, third thing is, in the reported speech, in this, what we'll be doing, we use any conjunction. Yes, I'll make you write these rules because people forget. We use conjunction like that. We connect it. When we remove inverted commas, we use conjunction. What sort of conjunction? We use that. Sometimes we use if. Sometimes we use whether. Fine. Sometimes we use why, what. It depends upon the sentence. Clear? So in this indirect speech or reported speech, because kisi ne report kiya hai isko. So I'll be saying reported speech. Clear? And beta, this verb. Verbs, sabko pata hai, verbs are the action words. Said, tell, hear. This is called a reporting verb. This area. Clear? This is called reporting verb. Clear? And this is reported speech. And rule number four now. Fourth rule says that reporting verb changes according to the sense. This is the reporting verb, said to. So it changes. If to is there, we change into told. It changes as per the sense. I'm just telling you the difference between direct speech and indirect speech. Humne koi rules start nahi kiye abhi. Clear? It is just an introduction to direct and indirect speech. Then after that, next rule says the tense of the reporting verb is never changed. Iska jo tense hai, agar yahan pe says hai, to wahan pe bhi says present hi rahega. If it is past, to wahan pe bhi past. Said tha, to we remained it told. The outer part, fine, inverted comma se pehle jo reporting verb hoti hai, its tense remains the same. Clear? This is another rule. And then mark of interrogation, exclamation. Suppose aapki direct speech mein yahan pe question pucha gaya. Are you feeling okay? Question mark. Fine. Sign of exclamation hai kuch. But in indirect speech, always we remove any kind of sign, whether it is interrogation, whether it is sign of exclamation. Indirect speech always ends with a full stop. Clear? This is the basic rules. Is it clear to all of you? Fine, I'll make you write. Children sitting at home, kindly send me thumbs up, beta. Is it clear? The basic rules? Yes. So, write down. This is clear. What is direct speech? Direct words. What is indirect speech? When we quote the words of others. Now, write down difference between direct and indirect speech. Same rules I'm going to make you write. Jo abhi samjhaye. Difference between direct and. So Bisham is asking, when we talk to a person, whether we use direct speech or indirect speech. But it depends upon the person. It can vary. One person can prefer to use direct speech. The other will be using indirect. Both are correct. Unless and until you are using the tenses correctly, both things are correct only. Fine. Nothing is wrong in that. So, difference between direct and indirect speech. Rule number one, we remove comma in the reported speech. Or you can write the comma is removed in the रिपोर्टेड स्पीच. फर्स्ट रूल इज डिफरेंस आपका जो है उसका फर्स्ट रूल है वी रिमूव कॉमा इन द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच और इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. फाइन, ए वन एंड सेम थिंग. सेकेंड रूल, इनवर्टेड कॉमाज आर ऑल्सो रिमूव्ड. इनवर्टेड कॉमाज, आई एन वी ई आर टी ई डी, इनवर्टेड कॉमाज, सी ओ एम एम ए एस. ओके, ट्वाइस यू हैव टू राइट एम, डोंट राइट सी ओ एम ए, दैट इज अनदर कॉमा. द कॉमाज, द इनवर्टेड कॉमाज आर ऑल्सो रिमूव्ड. दिस इज सेकेंड रूल. थर्ड रूल बेटा, रूल, थर्ड रूल इज रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अ कंजंक्शन. रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अ कंजंक्शन, हाइफ़न डालो, दैट कॉमा इफ कॉमा व्हाट व्हाई. लेट मी राइट दैट. Reported speech is introduced by a conjunction. Hyphen डाल के लिखो. That if, why, etc. Means it depends upon the sentence. What are you using? That if, what, why, etc. Next is the tense of the reporting verb is never changed. The tense of the reporting verb is never changed. Next is the tense of the reporting verb is never changed. Next is all kinds of sentences are changed into assertive sentences. All kinds of assertive means positive statement. All kinds of sentences are changed into assertive sentences. Whether they have asked a question or exclamation or anything, you will be making it into assertive. Fine, statement wala. Last rule is mark of interrogation and exclamation. Mark of, M-A-R-K. Mark of interrogation means question mark. And sign of exclamation are always changed into full stops. They are always changed into full stop. Clear? Now we'll be starting the transformation now. Okay? So we'll be starting the rules. Here your actual direct indirect speech starts. So write down rules, give the heading. Rule number one, rule number one. You can give the heading transformation of direct speech into indirect. That also you can write. Clear? Transformation of direct speech into indirect. First rule. Yes, boys. Rule number one. If the reporting verb is in the present or future, if the reporting verb is in present or future. This is the condition. Yes. Last boy, please tell me, what do you mean by reporting verb? I have already told you. Jaldi se batao. Reporting verb. Is it used before inverted commas or within inverted commas? Fine. Can you give me one example? Ram said that. Which one is the reporting verb here? Don't tell him. Said. Fine. See, I'm not asking the tense. The answer is no. In very easy language, I told you. I said Ram said to Shyam, suppose. So said to is reporting verb here. Jo report kar rahe. Fine. So please pay attention. That's why I asked you. You were not paying attention. Sit down, please. Yes. First rule, if the reporting verb is in the present or future tense, comma, the tense of the verb in the reported speech does not change. The tense of the verb in the reported speech does not change. Yes. Tell me, what is the reported speech in a sentence? Give me one example. I say, he said to them, who teaches you English? He said to them, comma, inverted comma, start, who teaches you English? Yahan pe reported speech kya hai? Yes, bad job. Fine, so whatever is within inverted commas, that is reported speech. Fine, beta. So what is written before commas? Whatever verb is used, said, told, inquired, any word which is used, that is our reporting verb. Don't get confused. It's very easy if you just pay attention. Clear? So, yes, beta, is it clear to all? Sitting at home, kindly send me thumbs up. 13 students. Fine, beta. So let's continue. Yes. Now, what is the rule? One example. Write down one example, then it will be clear to you. For example. Beta, ya to aise likhoge, for example, or you will write E dot G. Most of you write for E dot G dot. Aise likhte ho, that is wrong. EG stand for Exempla Gratia. Exempla Gratia means for example. Clear? So if you write like this na, for EG, it means kya ho gaya? For example. That is wrong. Clear? So either you will be writing pura likhna for example or E dot G dot. This small thing you should know. Exempla Gratia. Fine. Now, okay, rather than concentrating on this full form, let's continue on our rule. Fine. For example, now, the rule, I'm justifying the rule. They are saying, if reporting verb, that's why maine aapko bola, aapko clear hona chahiye. Don't sit dumb-headed, please. If you have doubt, do ask. You should know what is a reporting verb. Sabko clear hai? Reporting verb before inverted commas. They are saying rule is, if the reporting verb, like I said, he said to him. Yahan pe said jo hai, that is our reporting verb. If it is in the present or future tense, fine. The tense of the verb in the reported speech does not change. It's very easy. फाइन, जो विद इन इन्वर्टेड कॉमर्स है वी चेंज द टेंस ऑफ दैट ना, इफ इट इज इन द प्रेजेंट और फ्यूचर. सपोज ऐसे लिखा हुआ है ही सेव टू राम और ही विल टेल हिम कॉमा इन्वर्टेड कॉमा स्टार्ट. क्लियर? रिपोर्टिंग वर्ब अगर विल शैल में आ गई और प्रेजेंट टेंस सेज टेल्स, फाइन, देन यू देर इज नो नीड टू चेंज द टेंस विद इन द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच. वन एग्जाम्पल इज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, राइट डाउन Rohit says, comma, inverted comma, start, I am burning midnight oil. Means burning midnight oil means doing hard work, right? I am burning midnight oil, O-I-L, full stop, inverted comma, closes. Now, यहाँ पे क्या है? Rohit says. So, you will say कि अच्छा, reporting verb is in present tense. Rohit says that he is burning midnight oil. Is, am, are, fine? Same tense we are using. Clear? But am will be changing to is because we are using for Rohit. Rohit says that he is burning midnight oil, full stop. No commas, no inverted commas. Clear? Hanji, they are saying if the reporting verb, fine, is in this is the reporting verb, beta. To make it more clear, fine. If it is in present, says, hai na? So according to it, same tense, is, am, are wala same tense lagega, but pronoun will be changed. Fine. Rohit says that he is burning midnight oil. Same tense. It is easier for you. You no need to remember any tense change. Clear? Now, write down rule number 2. Rule number 1 is done. Rule number 2, if the reporting verb is in the past, ab yahan se this rule will carry n number of changes. Clear? Jo second rule hai, it has sub parts now. This is the main major part of reported speech. So write down, if the reporting verb is in the past tense, If the reporting verb is in the past tense, comma, the tense of the verb the tense of the verb in reported speech must be changed if the reporting verb is in the past tense. Comma, the tense of the verb in the reported speech must be changed into the corresponding past tense. Must be changed into the corresponding past tense. The tense of the verb must be changed into the must be changed into the corresponding past tense. Corresponding past tense. What does it mean? Let me make you understand. For example, write down. For example, the teacher said, comma, inverted comma, start. The teacher said, comma, inverted commas, start. Boys fail because they do not study regularly. Boys fail because they do not study regularly. Full stop, inverted comma, closes. I repeat, the teacher said, comma, inverted comma, start. Boys fail because they do not study regularly. Full stop, comma, closes. Now, firstly, you will see the reporting verb. The teacher said past me. So you will be changing into the corresponding past tense. So which tense is used here? Boys failed. Second form of verb is there. So your answer will be the teacher said that. Firstly, you will be adding conjunction. The teacher said that the boys failed because they did not study regularly. Fine? Yes. The teacher said that boys failed because they did not study regularly. Corresponding past tense mein change ho gaya. Wo do changes into did. Agar does laga hota, even then did mein change hota. The boy failed because he does not. Aise hota, even then did not aata. Clear? Now, beta, give the heading change of tenses. Give the heading. Yes, boys. Now, I guess it's time to ask a few questions. Very good. Stand up. Even I'm calling you. Is it important that he's calling you? Whole life baatein karni beta, aapko school aa rahe ho, so then please listen, otherwise sit at home. I'll be naming those students who need not come to school then. So now beta, the major part of reporting, reported speech starts here. This is change of. Just heading I'm giving with this chalk. I will be using white only, beta, just heading. Change of, what did I say? I said I'll be using white only, wait. Change of tenses. Now you should remember it. Beta, kal se kindly achhe se chalks rakhna yahan pe. I'm not having white chalks like this I'm having. Boys. Time to call some boys here, I guess. When they start talking, it's a reminder. You are reminding me that I need to stand. So change of tenses, fine. You will be making one table, fine. Here we will be writing that which tense changes into which one. So write down. Present indefinite changes into past indefinite. First one is present indefinite. Tenses you have already done. Changes to past indefinite. For example, write down do or does, do or does, it changes to did. So one example so that you can remember. Clear? Next is, we won't be doing examples now, okay? Just we will be doing rules directly because well is about to go and we'll continue it tomorrow. Do or does changes to did. Yes. I am preparing you that you need not depend upon others for even objective questions. You take it very casually. The child who knows the rules, he will be able to convert it in correct answer. Grammar is having heavy weightage, beta. Literature and grammar, they're going to carry higher weightage in your objectives. So Bell has gone. We'll continue tomorrow this table. Okay. Have a nice day, beta.